second born in a family of five. So currently I'm in Form 3. I study at Mangu High School. But before, I used to go to school as for my primary education. I used to go to school just here in Laikipia where we live, in a place in the place we are now called Rumuruti. And I started in that school since Taradi 1. My dad used to had some sheep and cows, so he used to sell them to pay for my school fees, which was around 1,000 shillings at the moment. By the time I was in class 4, my dad got it, so it challenging to continue paying my fees because of the drought which came along by the time I was in class 4, and all the cattle he had died. I think he was left with only around five and some sheep. So it got a bit challenging because here at home the children needed food plus my school fees. So he thought of taking me to another school, just around a public school. I was a bright student, so I used to be around position 1, 2, 3 most of the time. So when my dad came with the idea of taking me coming for my transfer at school, the teacher denied him the transfer because the teacher said he didn't want to leave bright students to go to another schools. After class 8, I was able to score 411 in my KCP and got an admission from Mangu High School, which was my dream school. Okay, I was happy since I got a chance in my dream school. But now the problem was my school fees. I kept on thinking where my school fees will come from. So there was Wings to Fly, there was KCB, there were many foundations. I was thinking of how I will go to school. I had an admission to my dream school, yes. But now the problem was the school fees. I was thinking where the school fees will come from. Yet back at home, my dad just went for some labor works here around, and that only catered for food for the children here back at home. It will not cater for more. So it was a bit challenging, yes. So I was even at a point of losing hope, but I still prayed and asked God to help me acquire some scholarship or to find some way of going to school. So when we were just here at home, we got in touch with some uncle of mine who knew some of our family members there in Nanyuki. So I don't know how, but the guy got in touch with Mr. Ndongo Nyoro, the manager of Affecto Foundation. He gave us the direction and he sent us fare. So we went until there and we met him. So he assured me that as for now, we have come to your help and we'll cater for your school fees, your shopping, and your everything. I was very happy indeed that I will join my dream school. So after that, I joined the school, and Affecto still continued paying for my school fees and catering for everything. And if I get a chance to be one of the pioneers in Affecto, I'll make sure that I do the same to the society as I'm done today. like helping the students, bright students from poor backgrounds, and giving back to my society and the society at large, and we'll make sure that will be done. Yeah, to give my gratitude to Afecto and assure them that I will continue working hard and I will score a very good grade in my KCSE and pursue my dream career, which is civil engineering. Yeah.